In this video presentation, we're looking at the practice of taking a supply to a switch. So no longer using the three-plate looping method discussed in previous video presentations, but this time directly taking a line, neutral and CPC down to the switch, making connections at the switch, and then taking a cable from the switch up to the lighting point. This is often used where there is a number of lighting points, such as LED downlighters, in one room. This system can also be converted to a two-way and two-way and intermediate switching as well. The cable bringing in the supply brings a brown permanent line connection, which is connected in this case into the common terminal, and also a neutral, which is into a connection. This is a maintenance-free connector block in this diagram, and also the CPC, which is secured in the earth terminal, in this case in the back of the box. The cable going out that will feed the lighting points has the brown switching line conductor connected in L1. Its blue conductor, which is a neutral, connected with the other neutral from the supply, in this case in the maintenance-free connector block, and the CPC secured also with the other CPCs in the earth terminal itself. So in this system, it means we only take one cable up to the lighting point, and that would have a switching line, neutral and CPC. However, if there was other lighting points in the same room coming on from the same switch, you just go from one lighting point to another, looping across the switching line, neutral and CPC, so all lighting points come on at the same time the switch is thrown. Let's see how we can convert this to two-way switching. So the conductors coming into the top switching point are identical as before. We've got a supply coming in, carrying a line, neutral and CPC conductors, and we've also got the one coming out, which is the switching line, neutral and CPC. We've replaced the one-way switch now for a two-way switch, and our conductors have been disconnected. Our two brown conductors were previously in common and L1. They've now been reattached to a two-way switch going in L1 and L2. We've introduced a three-core cable, which connects the two-way switch at the top with a new two-way switch in position. And we've used black for common, and we've identified that with brown sleeving. And the other two conductors, doesn't matter which one goes in L1 and which one goes in L2. So we've used brown and grey, and again the grey conductor has been identified with brown sleeving because the black and grey are both switching line conductors. So we've introduced a three core from the top switch to our new switching position. Both switches are now two-way switches, and our connections in our bottom switch are black for common, identified with brown sleeving. And it doesn't matter which way around, we have our brown conductor and our grey identified with brown sleeving into L1 and L2. So now we've achieved two-way switching of our lighting circuit. So now we've got two-way and intermediate switching. Our original switching position now is at the top position, and our second switch down was the one that was two-way in our previous presentation. And we've added an extra cable in down to the bottom switch. However, our switching arrangement has changed slightly. The top switch is still a two-way switch, the middle switch is now an intermediate switch, and the bottom new switching position is a two-way switch. Remembering the connections in the top switch are identical to previously discussed, and the bottom switch are also identical to previously discussed. The black conductor within the intermediate switch on both sides of the through crimp is identified with brown sleeving and is joined together. The three core, either from the top switch coming down or the bottom switch coming up, has its brown and grey conductor either connected in the bottom of the intermediate switch or in the top of the intermediate switch,